Ladies and gentlemen, we are K&A Theatricals, a performing arts company born in Hollywood, home in Georgia, and worldwide as the show must go online. Our talented cast presents for you now hits from Oliver, The Secret Garden, Into the Woods, and Annie. Welcome to Broadway Baby and Beyond.
This hit musical Annie is set in New York City during the age of the Great Depression. Many hopeful people move to the Big Apple to find a better life. Here is the star-to-be on her first day in NYC. After escaping from the orphanage for a day, Annie is caught by a policeman and brought back to Miss Hannigan.
Come in.
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan. We found your runaway.
Oh, poor pumpkin out there in the freezing cold. It's just your thin sweater. I hope he didn't catch influenza. Thank you so much, officer. Now you. Glad to be back,
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
Liar. What's the one thing I always taught you? Never tell a lie.
Miss Hannigan?
Yeah?
I'm Grace Farrell, private secretary to Oliver Warbucks.
The Oliver Warbucks? The millionaire?
The billionaire. Mr. Warbucks has decided to invite an orphan to spend the Christmas holidays at his home.
Oh, well, what sort of orphan did he have in mind?
Well, she should be friendly.
Uh-huh.
And intelligent.
M-I-S-S-I-S-S-I-P-P-I.
And cheerful.
Mm-hmm.
And,
how old?
Age doesn't really matter. See, 8, 9, 10, 11. What about this child right here?
Annie! Oh, no! No, you don't want Annie!
Annie, would you like to spend the next 2 weeks at Mr. Warbucks' home?
I would love to!
She'll get her coat. I'll take her right along now.
I don't have no coat.
Then we'll buy her one. Merry Christmas! Come along, Annie. Mr. Warbucks' limousine is waiting to take us to his mansion.
Annie and Grace arrive at Warbucks' mansion, and they are greeted by his staff.
Welcome to Mr. Warbucks' mansion. Now, Annie, you are our guest, and for the next few weeks, you will have a swell time. Now, Cecile will pick out all your clothes.
Thanks, Rice Color. No blue, I think.
Your bath is drawn by Mrs. Green.
So, no bubbles, I think.
Annette comes in to make your bed.
So, no sashes, I think.
I think I'm gonna like it here.
When you wake, ring for Drake. Drake will bring your tray. When you're through, Mrs. Hugh comes to take it away.
Get me now! Holy cow! Could someone
Annie meets Mr. Warbucks, and he decides to adopt her. Grace Farrow goes back to the orphanage to tell Miss Hannigan the good news.
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan. Mr. Warbucks is delighted with Annie, and Annie is having the time of her life. She and Mr. Warbucks are practically inseparable. They go everywhere together, and she just loves her new coat. She never takes it off. Miss Hannigan, I know you're busy, but this has to be signed and sent back to Mr. Donatelli at the Board of Orphans by no later than 10 o'clock tomorrow morning. Mr. Warbucks is so taken with Annie that, guess what? He wants to adopt her. And Mr. Warbucks asked me to drop by in person to tell you that Annie won't ever be coming back here. Well, good day to you, Miss Hannigan.
Pardon me, sweetheart. I insist on coming to see.
They finally let you out of prison! What were you in for this time?
Oh, gee, just when I threw an amount of $1,100.
Well, why do you say that?
The rooster smuggled him out of $1,100.
Oh, Lo. Sis, I'd like you to meet a friend of mine.
Josie Sin.
Miss Lily St. Regis.
I named after the hotel.
Which floor? Rooster, do me a favor. Get out of here. Take the St. Regis with you.
Aw,
Looking for another handout?
No, I got $80 coming in the mail on Thursday. I only need 10 to find you.
Not even a nickel for the subway, Rooster.
$5, Aggie.
$5? I gotta laugh. You and all your big talk gonna be living in clover.
Well, this ain't exactly Buckingham Palace. You're doing how I'm doing.
Lousy.
How do the two Hannigan kids live up here? Oh, skids.
Gotta get there before you die.
You don't get there, that's no end for me.
You stack the aces,
you meet the
guy. Mother dear, how can we follow?
So Miss Hannigan, Lily, and Rooster go off to Easy Street. Warbucks gives Annie a new locket to replace her broken one. Annie does not want to give up her old locket.
No. Please don't make me take my locket off. My mother and father left it with me when they left me at the orphanage. And there was a note too. They're coming back for me. And I know I'll be near for Christmas. I'm really lucky, but I don't know how to say it. The one thing I want in the whole world is to find my mother and father, and to be like other kids, with folks of my own.
Mr. Warbucks decides to help Annie find her real mom and dad.
Annie's on the radio? I wish I was on the radio. So for all the hours of smiles, family, this is Bert Healy saying...
Hey, Hobo Man, hey, Dapper Dan, you both got your style.
The Brody are never fully dressed without a smile. Your clothes may be woefully, they stand out of mind, but brother, you're...
what you wear from ear to ear, and not from head to toe.
That matters.
So senator, so janitor, so long for a while, remember you'll never fully dress. Though you may wear the vest, you're never fully dressed without a smile.
Smile, darling, smile!
The classical musical, Oliver, tells Charles Dickinson's tragic tale of Oliver Twist. Like Annie, this poor orphan boy is searching for a family and love.
Where is the love? Does it fall from skies above? Is it underneath a willow tree?
Run by Fagin and led by lead pickpocket, the artful Dodger.
Hello, Oliver. My name is Dodger. Welcome to the family.
Time to consider race, we can't skip.
Dodger and the pickpockets take Oliver into their family of pickpockets. Beck is one of the pickpockets who teaches them all their proper English manners.
How's it going then, Dodger?
Hello, Beck. It's our bargain episode.
And don't let your petticoats go tangling in the mud, my darling.
I'll go last.
No, I'll go last, if you insist. I'll do anything for you, dear. Anything for you mean everything to me. I know that I'll go anywhere for your smile. Anywhere for your smile. Everywhere I see.
Would you lace my shoe?
Anything.
Paint your face bright blue.
Anything.
Catch a kangaroo.
Anything.
Go to Timbuktu.
And back again, I'd risk
everything
for one
kiss.
Everything, yes I do.
Anything, anything for you.
And right now, Oliver, you just copy Dodger and I'll help you out with the words, alright? So, it's I'll do anything.
For you, dear.
Would you lace my shoe?
Anything.
Paint your face bright blue?
Anything.
Catch a kangaroo?
Anything.
Go to Timbuktu?
And back again.
I'd risk
everything
for one kiss.
Everything.
Yes, I do.
Anything. Anything for you.
Very good, Dodger. Very good, Oliver.
Fagin, the crafty leader of the pickpockets, greets Bet and Nancy, a barmaid with a heart of gold.
Nancy, Bet, now you be careful. Too much danger is never good for young ladies like you.
What's wrong with a bit of danger then, Mr. Fagin?
Small pleasures, who would deny us these?
Gin toddies, large measures, now skimpin' if you please. I rough it.
I love it, life is a game of chance. I never tire of it,
leading this merry dance.
If you don't mind having to go without things,
it's a fine life.
It's a fine life, though it ain't all jolly and pleasure outings.
It's a fine life.
It's a fine life when you got someone to love. You forget your cares and strife.
Let the whole world frown at us. Let them all look down on us. It's a fine,
fine life.
All right, now, Bet, it's your turn.
No flounces, no feathers, no frills and fairy lows. All winds and all weathers
ain't good for fancy clothes. These trappings,
these tatters,
these we can just afford. What future
matters?
We've got a bed and board. If you don't mind having to like a lump it, it's a fine life.
It's a fine life. Don't eat sipping and eating crumpet. It's a fine life.
It's a fine life. Not for me, a happy home, happy husband. Happy wife, though it sometimes touches me.
For the likes as such as me,
mind a fine, fine life.
When Nancy saves Oliver from the wicked ways of the pickpockets, Fagin is left alone and full of questions about his life.
A man's got a heart, it's deep. Joke it apart as it is. And though I'd be the same, the first one I wasn't a saint. I'm finding it hard to be really as black as they paint. I'm reviewing the situation. Can a fellow be a villain all his life? All the trials and tribulations meant to settle down and get myself a wife. Wife for cook and sew for me and come and go for me. Go for me and nag at me, the finger she would wag at me. Money she would take for me, her misery she'd pay for me. I think I better think it out again. A wife you could keep anyway. I'd rather sleep anyway. Left without anyone in the world, and I'm starting from now. So how to win friends and influence people? So how? I'm reviewing the situation. I must quickly look up everyone I know. Title people with a stature who can help me make a real impressive show. I will own a suite at Claridge's and run a feat of courage and wave at all the duchesses and friendliness as much as is letting up my new say good morrow to you, magistrate. I think I better take it out again. So where shall I go, somebody? Who do I know? Nobody. All my dearest companions have always been villains and thieves. So at my time of life, I should start turning over new leaves. I'm reviewing the situation. If you want to read, you've got to earn a ball. Is it such a humiliation for a robber to perform an honest job? So a job I'm getting possibly, I wonder who might possibly be. Wonder if you'll take to me, what bonuses you make to me. I started late and finish late and normal rate, but oh, but wait. Think it better, think it out, I think it better, think it out again. I think it better, think it out again. What happens when I'm 70? Must come a time, 70, when you're old and it's cold and who cares if you live or you die? Your one consolation's the money you may have put by. I'm reviewing the situation. I'm a baron and a baron, I shall stay. You'll be seen, no transformation. But it's wrong to be a rogue in every way. I don't want nobody hurt for me. You're made to detect for me. This rotten life is not for me. It's getting far too hot for me. There's no in-between for me. Who will change the scene for me? Don't want nobody robbed for me, but who will find a job for me? Hey. I think I'd better think it out again. Hey.
When we last saw Cinderella from Into the Woods, she had run away from the prince and was missing her shoe. She meets up with the baker's wife, who wants to know all about Prince Charming.
He's a very nice prince.
And?
It's a very nice bowl.
And?
When I entered, they trumpeted.
And? The prince?
Oh, the prince.
Yes, the prince.
Well, he's tall.
Is that all? Did you dance? Is he charming? They say that he's charming.
I did nothing but dance.
Yes. And
it made a nice change.
No, the prince.
Oh, the
yes,
prince.
The prince.
He's charmed for a prince, I guess.
You guess.
I don't need a wide range, and it's all very strange.
But why would you run away?
It's not quite what I expected.
What? Princes and castles and counts.
I have no experience with those things.
But you will return to the festival tomorrow evening.
Yes. No. I don't know.
You don't know? What I wouldn't give to be in your shoes. What slippers? As pure as gold.
I must get home.
No, no, wait. I need your shoes.
Cinderella's prince meets the baker's wife in the woods, and he sweeps her off her feet with a kiss. That is over in just a moment.
I must leave you.
Why?
The giant.
Oh, the giant. I almost forgot. Will we find each other in the woods again?
This was just a moment in the woods. Our moment shimmering and lovely and sad. Leave the moment, just be glad for the moment that we had. Every moment is a moment when you're in the woods. Now, I must go off and slay the giant. That is what the next moment holds for me. I shall never forget you. How brave you are to be alone in the woods. And how alive you made me feel.
What was that?
Was that me? Was that him? Did a prince really kiss me? And kiss me, and kiss me. And did I kiss him back? Was it wrong? Am I mad? Is that all? Does he miss me? Was he suddenly getting bored with me? Wake up, stop dreaming, stop ranting about the woods. It's not the seeming, what is it about the woods? Back to life, back to scent, back to child, back to husband, you can't live in the woods. There are vows, there are ties, there are needs, there are standards, there are should and shoulds. Why not both instead? There's the answer if you're clever. Have a child for more than a baker for bread, to prince or whatever. Never it's these woods. Face the facts, find the boy, join the group, stop the giant, just get out of these woods. Was that him? Yes, it was. Was that me? No, it wasn't. Just a trick. Just a moment, one peculiar passing moment. Must it all be either less or more, either plain or grand? Is it always or is it never and? That's what woods are for those moments in the woods. Oh, if life were made of moments, even now and then a bad one. But if life were only moments, then you'd never know you had one. First a witch, then a child, then a prince, then a moment. Who can live in the woods? To get what you wish, only just for a moment. These are dangerous woods. Let the moment go. Don't forget it for a moment, though. Just remembering you've had an and when you're back to or makes the or mean more than it did before. Now I understand.
The fairy tale characters in Into the Woods all search for the giant who is terrorizing their world. The witch turns into a beautiful enchantress and warns them that time is almost up.
It's the last midnight.
fly, stole a little gold, broke a little vow. Did you? How to get your prince, how to get your cow, how to get your wish, doesn't matter how, anyway it doesn't matter now. You're so nice, you're not good, you're not bad, you're just nice. I'm not good, I'm not nice, I'm just right. Coming along, everybody down on all fours, or run her way, lost something to get, punish me the way you did then. Cause the hunch and the wave, this fun and the blue, and the doom, and the
Welcome to the Secret Garden, a beautiful forgotten place that used to be the treasure and joy of a beautiful and kind mother.
Clusters of crocus, purple and gold, blankets of pansies out from the cold.
Safe from the chill.
Mary Lennox was a sad young girl whose parents died from cholera in India. She moved to live with her Uncle Archie in London, who was grieving the loss of his wife, Lily, who had a beautiful garden. Mary discovers Lily's garden, but it is not thriving and healthy. It is dead. Dickon the gardener greets Mary.
Hey up! Hello there, Mary.
Hello there.
Why are you in such a bad temper?
The garden is dead, Dickon. This is the most forgotten place I have ever seen, with loose great branches and dead roots and leaves all tangled up on the ground.
Now, Mary, did you take a real close look at anything? The strongest roses will fare thrive on being neglected if the soil is rich enough.
You mean it might be alive? But how can we tell?
Oh, I can tell if the thing is wick.
Wick? I've heard Ben say wick.
When a thing is wick, it has a life about it. Now maybe not a life like you and me. Somewhere there's a single streak of green inside it. Come, let me show you what I mean. When a thing is wick, it has a light around it. Now maybe not a light that you can see. But hiding down below, sparks asleep inside it. It's waiting for the right time to be seen. You clear away the dead parts so the tender buds can form. Loosen up the earth and let the roots get warm. Let the roots get warm. Come a mild day, come a warm rain, come a snowdrop a coming up. Come a lily, come a lilac, come to call, all of us come and see.
When a thing is weak and someone cares about it, and comes to work each day like you and me, will it grow?
It will.
Then have no doubt about it, we'll have the grandest garden ever seen. Oh, Dickon, I want it all to be wick. Would you come and look at it with me?
Come every day, rain or shine, if
but
you want me. All that God needs is for us to come wake it up.
Archie takes it back. Where no one sees my life inside, where I can
garden begins to groan with Mary and Dickon tending it. Back in Uncle Archie's mansion, Mary hears an eerie sound. Crying is from Colin, Lily's bedridden son. Mary wants to help Colin get better by showing him his mother's garden. However, her uncle is very upset that Mary had discovered this garden and threatens to send her away. Martha, Mary's chambermaid, has words of hope and strength for Mary.
What you got to do is finish what you have done. I don't know just how, but it's not over. Terror in your eyes. What you do then is you tell yourself to wake up and you say, it's this day, not me, that's bound to go away. Hold on, the night will soon be by. Hold on, don't even ask how long or why. Child, hold on to what you know is true. Until you get through, child or child, and it doesn't even matter if the danger and the doom come from up above or down below, or just come flying at you from across the room. When you see a man who's raging and he's jealous and he fears that you walk through walls he's hid behind. To wait it out and say,